Dear students, myself Nitin Kumar. I am assistant professor in National Institute of Food Technology, Entrepreneurship and Management, Tungli, Haryana. I welcome you all to EPG Pathshala, and today I am going to deliver a talk on advanced drying process for fruits and vegetables from a paper, Technology of Fruits and Vegetables. The objective of today's lecture is to know about the drawbacks of conventional drying vis-a-vis to know some of the basic terminology used in the advanced drying, as also to know the advanced drying methods used for fruits and vegetables. And at last, there must be some limitations, so we are going to discuss some of the limitations of advanced drying methods. As we know, fruits and vegetables are characterized with high moisture content product and hence have short shelf life. Higher the amount of moisture content means shorter is the shelf life, because all microbes basically grow on the water. So reduction in the moisture content is the best way to obtain a higher shelf life for fruits and vegetables. There are several conventional techniques like solar drying, clean drying, cabinet drying have been used for drying of fruits and vegetables from ancient times. They might have several advantages as well as several disadvantages, which I have already discussed in one of the previous paper. So conventional drying techniques require more time for drying and provide the product of inferior quality in general. But consumer demands has been increasing nowadays for a dried product which is bearing the original characteristic, like the fresh product. That means flavor and aroma, sometimes this sense, aroma, taste should be as light, just like the original fruits prior to the drying. This requires the development of such processing methods as well as the dryer that can prevent or reduce the adverse effect of conventional drying. Scientists are continuously working on the advancement of existing drying practices used nowadays for the drying of fruits and vegetables to overcome all the drawbacks which we are encountered nowadays. So today in this chapter, some of the advantages of drying technologies will be discussed. Let us discuss about the demerits of conventional drying techniques. Although the conventional drying methods like sun drying, solar drying have some basic advantages like utilization of free solar energy, low capital as well as low operating cost, however, they have few demerits as well as limitations, which are very much significant in terms of hygiene and high volume production. In this slide, there are some of the disadvantages mentioned here. The first one, drying process requires longer time. That means in case of conventional drying, the drying process requires longer time in comparison to the advanced drying processes. The dried product is often of poor quality. The reason being because in case of open drying, it is not hygienically maintained. The dust comes and sticks with the cut fruits as well as vegetables. So the drying procedure is unhygienic in case of open air drying. In case of conventional drying like sun drying or open air drying, we need large space. So that means we need large space for the conventional drying techniques. There are chances of shrinkage of product. Shrinkage of product means there is removal of moisture in uncontrolled way, and the product, that is the fruits and vegetables, become shrink. The texture become harder in case of conventional drying. The reason being the texture is almost in contact with the sun rays, and the texture achieve high amount of heat and ultimately the texture becomes harder. There is a loss of color as well as aroma in case of conventional drying because of uncontrolled heat application. That is the reason we need to improve the conventional air drying method for fruits and vegetables so that we have the possibilities of drying new product, we have a possibilities to achieve high thermal efficiencies as well as capacities. The quality of dry products remain good in case of advanced drying procedure, and we can have some quality control measurements. All the parameters, we can set quality control parameters in case of advanced dryer. The advanced dryer which we are going to discuss in this module are less environmental threat, less toxic, it reduces explosion. Those dryers are safe in operation, the operational costs are less in compared to the conventional drying. It needs less time to dry and it gives good quality of dried product. In case of advanced drying, there is a possibilities to incorporate renewable energy that is free available in the nature, right? Sun rays, tidal and other resources to incorporate with the dryer, advanced dryer. So before we discuss about the advanced or the improved method of drying, I would like to discuss some of the basic terminology which we'll supposed to know before the discussion of advanced methods of drying technology, like glass transition temperature. At certain temperature and moisture content, some food material behaves like highly viscous metastable amorphous material of low bulk density with either rubbery or glassy characteristics. The temperature is known as glass transition temperature of the amorphous concentrated solution. As the temperature increases above the glass transition temperature, various changes such as increase in free volume, decrease of viscosity, increase of specific heat and increases of thermal expansion are noticed. There is another properties that we known as triple point. The triple point of any substance is the combination of temperature, pressure at which three phases, gas, liquid and solid of the substance exist in thermodynamically equilibrium state. As we know, the triple point of water has certain values of 0.01 degree centigrade at 0.006 atmospheric pressure. The next properties is apparent density, which is defined as the ratio between the apparent volume and the dry mass of a food sample. The apparent density can be expressed in terms of kilogram per meter cube. And it depends on the form of particle, the composition of a substance, and the method of storage. The volume taken by the product includes void space. That's why it depends on the method of storage, and basically it depends on the apparent volume. Next one is fluidization. It is a stage at which a bed of solid particle acquires fluid-like properties. That means all the food samples, fruits and vegetables are in the stage of suspension and it is almost 1 mm or 2 mm away from the conveyor belt and the air is allowed from the bottom of bed. The basic advantage of this fluidization is that the air can have maximum surface area contact with individual fruits as well as the vegetables or the particles, and we have high amount of heat transfers. Next is sorption capacity. which is defined as the mass of water absorbed by the unit mass of solvent at a given relative humidity and expressed through a sorption isotherm. At equilibrium, the relationship between water content and equilibrium humidity of a material can be displayed graphically by a curve known as moisture sorption isotherm. And for each humidity value, a sorption isotherm indicates corresponding water content value at given constant temperature. Sorption capacity is important during convective drying of a product by a hot air flow. Next is osmosis. It is defined as movement of molecule through a semi-permeable membrane from a place of higher concentration to a place of lower concentration until the concentration on both sides is equal. Osmotic dehydration can remove 50% of water from fresh ripe fruits like banana, mango, papaya, apple, and other tropical fruits. It requires low temperature and energy. Every fruit or vegetable or every food products have the pore, and from that pores the water molecules comes from the center to the surface of a product, and that's why the dehydrations can remove 50% of the water from a fresh food, and it can preserve, maintain some amount of freshness for the fruits or the food products. We are now going to discuss some of the advanced technique for drying of fruits and vegetables. The first one is fluidized bed drying. In case of fluidized bed drying, whole or diced fruits or vegetable may be dried. This technique can be used either in batch or continuous with a food particle size in the range of 20 micron to 10 mm. A fluidized bed is formed when the food particulates are subjected to pressurized fluid through the porous plate, and generally hot air is allowed to pass from the bottom of plates so that the food particulates, which are in a small size, achieve the suspension stage or the fluidization stage. The food achieves the gentle boiling motion and gets dried till it leaves from the dryer. In this, we can achieve several combination like vibrofluidized, spouted bed dryer, or pulse fluidized are also used for drying of fruits or vegetables. Basically, the drying occurs in fall in late period, and the drying time relatively is smaller compared to conventional hot air dryer. Hence, the material can uniformly dried with the preservation of nutrients. In general, beans, onion, potatoes are used for fluidized bed drying. Vacuum drying. High temperature drying can lead to the destruction of heat sensitive nutrients, sometimes loss of color as well as aroma. That's why vacuum drying come into practice. And in case of vacuum drying, raw pressure and a heating source is used for dehydration of foods. Hence, water from fruits and vegetables vaporizes at very low temperature corresponding to the atmospheric condition. In addition, some amount of oxidative reactions are also prevented in vacuum drying due to low level of oxygen, and ultimately a higher quality of product without any shrinkage can be achieved. This process is more energy efficient and quick in removing water from food product. The drying rate are also improved in vacuum drying. In some cases, it can added with the microwave or freeze drying are also carried out under vacuum. The feeder shows a plate vacuum dryer in which there is a steam inlet and provision to maintain vacuum. The plates are heated up and the condensate steams out. High value products like peach, pears, apricot and high sugar fruit are subjected to vacuum drying. Freeze drying. Freeze drying is a dehydration technique where water is removed from frozen state to directly vapor by means of sublimation. The total process carried out into four steps: pre-treatment, freezing, sublimation of ice, which is also known as primary drying, desorption of the water bond to the solid, termed as secondary drying. The food product, which is of having high value as well as heat sensitive, such as coffee, fruits, vegetable, etc., are dried by freeze drying. Heat is provided below melting temperature and drying takes place under vacuum condition below the triple point of water. The triple point of water is the point at which the water state adjusting all the three phases, gases, liquid as well as solid, and the triple point of water is 0.01 degree centigrade and 0.006 atmospheric pressure. Superheated steam drying. So instead of hot air, superheated steam can be used as a drying medium in a convective dryer. In conventional dryer like rotary, flash, fluidized bed, it can be converted into superheated steam dryer. It is one of the energy efficient operation as the net energy requirement can be minimized by using the exhaust somewhere else in the plant. As per the diagram cited here, we may see closed system. There is a closed system and steam comes from the boiler, and that steam is allowed to heat, and afterwards the steam is once again recycled back to the boiler. As the superheated steam does not contain oxygen, any kind of oxidative or combustion reaction are also not take place during the process. Simultaneously, the risk of fire as well as explosion hazard is also avoided here. The product quality after drying is good compared to the conventional hot air dryer. The superheated steam can also be utilized for sterilization, blanching, deodorization of food product during the drying process. The product required high standards of hygiene products processing, like high nutritive foods and pharmaceutical product can be processed by using superheated steam. Heat pump drying. Heat pump drying can be done at a relatively low temperature and humidity in compared to the conventional type hot air dryer. Auxiliary heaters are used for better control inside a dryer cabinet. The possibilities to operate under a wide range of operating conditions such as air humidity as well as air temperature, which makes heat pump drying more useful in case of food having volatile components. The drying system shows here, which uses a low temperature dehumidified air as a convective drying medium. A heat pump is used for dehumidification and heating of the drying air. The sensible and latent heat are recovered by heat pump due to the condensation of drying air. The dehumidified air is heated with the help of recovered heat, and hence we can achieve high energy efficiency in this process. Now I am going to discuss one of the very interesting technology that we know, microwave drying technology or microwave assisted drying, which is a rapid dehydration technique and can be applied to the fruits and vegetable. So actually microwave interact directly with the polar molecule. Water is a polar molecule and it interact with the microwaves and generate heat for evaporation of moisture. To increase the drying rate of fruits and vegetable, microwave heating can be used in combination with hot air drying, microwave vacuum drying, microwave freeze drying and fluidized bed drying. The process can be conducted at low temperature to retain product quality. So we are going to discuss how the microwaves work actually. The drying occurs into three steps, and the step one is, it is termed as heating up period, in which microwave energy penetrates within the moist material. The temperature of product increases gradually and the moisture releases at smaller rates. So the first step in which microwaves actually penetrate inside the food product and initiate the heating process. The step two, which is a rapid drying process in which temperature profile established and microwave is used to vaporize the moisture. So step two is actually the process in which the rate of moisture migration is different and it is high in comparison to the step one. The rate of moisture migration depends on the amount of moisture present, the porosity, the roundness of fruits, and the shape and size of fruits or vegetables. So the fruits which is spherical in nature will have high amount of microwave penetration inside the food and ultimately high amount of heat moisture transfer from the food particles. Step 3, the drying rate once again reduces along with the moisture to a stage where energy required for moisture vaporization is comparatively less than thermal energy converted from microwaves. So in stage 2, that is step 2, high amount of energy is required. Osmotic dehydration. The osmotic dehydration is a technique that not only extended the shelf life of fruits and vegetables, but also retains the flavor, nutritional values, pigment. Up to 50% moisture can be removed by osmotic dehydration from fresh ripened fruits like banana, mangoes, sapotas, papayas, apples can be used for osmotic dehydration. Generally, vacuum drying and air drying is used in combination with osmotic dehydration. The process completes in three stages. The first step is osmotic dehydration, second one vacuum or air drying, third one is packaging. Osmosis is done by dipping or spreading the fruits and vegetables in osmotic agent such as glucose, sorbitol, sucrose and salts in a specific conditions. The purpose of osmotic will give the water from fruits move to the sugar syrup due to the osmosis, that is because of the pressure gradients. Maximum moisture loss occurs in a final drying of the fruits and vegetable, which is done in vacuum or air drying, depending on the nature of products and the cost considerations. The dehydrated product by osmotic dehydration can be used as a confectionery item like ready-to-eat snacks items. The final product will give better appearance, taste, flavor and color compared to the conventional method of drying. Now we are going to discuss ultrasonic drying. For drying of heat-sensitive food stuff, use of high-power ultrasound is very useful. In this process, high-intensity ultrasonic vibration, which leads to some physiochemical changes on the process or the product, while a low-frequency power ultrasound develops a series of alternative compression and expansion throughout the solid, which results some sponge effect and by means of this, the moisture present inside the food leaves the food material. Combination of both, that is high intensity ultrasonic vibration and low frequency power ultrasound, will give loss of moisture as the microscopic pores of the sponge helps the moisture to come on the surface. Ultrasound waves can be used as one of the pre-treatment option for the fruits and vegetable drying followed by hot air drying or osmotic dehydration. That means in ultrasonic drying, the moistures are allowed to come on the surface of food material, and afterwards hot air drying will take place for the further drying of food or vegetables. So these perform the drying operations at a lower temperature and in a shorter time. Nowadays ultrasonic drying are very much useful in case of high value product or high nutritive or high sensitive foodstuffs. Supercritical drying. First, we are going to discuss the working principle of supercritical drying, how it works. It works on the principle of elimination of surface tension by achieving the critical point of moisture. When the pressure and temperature of sample are raised above the critical point of moisture in an autoclave, surface tension disappears and the solvent can be displaced easily without affecting the food surface. So as far as supercritical drying is concerned, one can achieve supercritical drying in two ways: by supercritical transition of original solvent and by supercritical transitions of CO2 or low critical parameter solvent. In case of supercritical transition of CO2, drying process is very expensive. To wash away all water present, acetone solution is used first, which develops the miscibility between two fluids. The acetone is then washed away with the high pressure liquid carbon dioxide and then heated until its temperature goes beyond the critical point, that is 304.2 Kelvin at 7.39 MPa, at which the pressure can be gradually released, allowing the gas to escape and leaving a dry product. The purpose of using CO2 as supercritical fluid because of its chemically inertness, odorless, tasteless, non-toxicity, non-flammable, non-explosive, inexpensive, easily available and easy to obtain, and to obtain in a pure form. If we see the photographs here, we can easily find out the critical pressure, the pressure versus temperature, where solids, liquids as well as gaseous phase are extensively distinguished by the means of sublimation line, boiling lines, and all are below the critical point. Above the critical point, this we achieve supercritical fluid. So now I am going to discuss a hybrid drying process or a combination drying techniques, which are very much famous nowadays because it receives the benefit of individual drying process. We have discussed lot of drying practices like supercritical, microwave, ultrasonic, and others. They might have several advantages also, and as well as disadvantages also. If we combine two technologies or two drying practice together, the advantages might be on the higher side. So the best example of hybrid drying is the use of solar energy along with any conventional drying practice like hot air oven, which is very much common for fruits and vegetables. The use of hybrid drying system always provide the product of better quality than that of produce from any similar drying method. A number of drying terminations can be utilized. So I want to give further more example on this, that is adding of microwave system to a spouted bed system, solar assisted drying, hot air drying and freeze drying can be used together to have a good quality product at the end of drying. Although advanced drying techniques have several advantages over conventional drying process as discussed in this module, but the advanced drying process also have some of the limitations like high capital cost, because the equipment, the drying process which we discuss here, it needs generation of low vacuum in some of the cases. In some of the cases, we need supercritical vapor, supercritical gases, so it inbuilt high amount of cost to the process. The process is almost very more complex in terms of conventional drying, and for this we need some technical person. The third disadvantage is, which I have cited here, is high electricity cost. To create in vacuum, to pump heat, to use heat pump, electricity will be required at some point of time. So it underdove for high electrical cost. It cannot be used for food product undergoing melting and gas transition stage. For advanced drying equipment or the dryer, we need regular maintenance. Some of the dryer needed CFCs for the refrigeration part, and we know that chlorofluorocarbon based refrigeration systems are obsolete and in the verge of ban throughout the world in 2050. Some of the advanced drying process or the dryer needs the time for initializations and the stabilizations of process. That means for the some of the days, it consume more time comparable to the convective or the conventional dryer. But in nutshell, we can see the for high nutritive value, for high heat sensitive product, we can certainly go for some advanced drying practices or advanced drying dryer as we discuss. So at the end, we can summarize the following, that the fruits and vegetables have high moisture content and it's very perishable in nature, and if we doesn't apply any methodology for drying, it will going to be deteriorate very soon. In case of conventional drying methods, which are very much common, there are so many limitations as well as disadvantages, mostly in terms of hygiene as well as quality. So that's why advanced drying technology comes into the picture, and there are so many scientists working on that advanced drying practices. The advantage of advanced drying technologies is the final product is of better quality and it retains the freshness as desired by the customers or consumers. These technology are frequently used nowadays and ensuring maximum energy utilizations. So at the end, I would like to say that advanced drying technologies are better than conventional drying technologies, but if we use hybrid drying technology, we can have advantage of free energy source from the sun, and we can incorporate with solar dryer, or we can incorporate with the hot air dryer technology, and we can achieve good product with less energy consumptions. Thank you.